In today's video, I will show you how to set up a remote connection for your Netcloud web server using DDNS or Dynamic DNS. This is the most request tutorial, so here we go. You ask and I deliver it. And before we get started, I just want to make sure two things: that your web Netcloud web server actually have HTTPS enforced, and as well as you have enabled your two-factor authenticator. The two-factor authenticator are going to ask an extra security layer for your web server. It doesn't mean that you are not vulnerable to attack. You're still vulnerable to attack if you explore your Netcloud web server out at, on the internet. It's just something to keep in mind. So if you're going to decide to keep your RIVAC or you know, sensitive data on your Netcloud server, make sure that you encrypt them. And before we get started, even though the tutorial is on TrueNAS Core, it should work the same way on FreeNAS 11.43 as well as FreeNAS 11.42. And if you don't know how to enable HTTPS or how to enable two-factor authentication on your Netcloud web server, I have a tutorial on how to do that. If you head to my channel and you go to playlist under Netcloud, you're gonna have all the tutorial for Netcloud on how to enforce HTTPS as well as enable two-factor authentications. And all right, with that, let's get started. Before we can do the setup for DDNS on TrueNAS, we're gonna need to set up the A record on ClouDNS. So for the closures, I don't get paid by ClouDNS to do the tutorial. It's just I've been using them and that's why I'm using this for this tutorial. You can use whatever domain provider out there on the internet, but before you purchase them, just make sure that they have a DNS validations. They're supporting DNS validations. The reason why you want that is because if you're gonna use this for let encrypt certificate expire every 90 days. So if you have DNS validations, you can automate the process. You don't have to manually renew them, and they make life a lot easier. All right, let's get started. So I'm gonna go to my sysadmin 102.tech and I'm gonna create a record, and I'm gonna add a new one. And the type of record is gonna be a record, TTL gonna be 1 hour, and I'm gonna call it netcloud.sysadmin102.tech. I believe ClouDNS actually offer a free one too. It's gonna be a generic domain. And port 2, I'm gonna put in there the RIVAC IP address 1.8.4.1.192.168.141. Just so when I update the DNS, DDNS from TrueNAS, it's gonna point to, it's gonna update it with my public IP address. So that's what I know it actually working. All right, I'm gonna go back to, if you see the two up and down arrow right here, dynamic URL, you click on that one. We're gonna activate it and we're gonna copy the wget command. And we're gonna go back to TrueNAS under tasks, cron jobs. We're gonna add a new one and decryption. We're gonna name it DDNS for dynamic DNS. Gonna paste the command in there and we're gonna run at root user. And we're gonna schedule to run hourly to match the TTL of 1 hour. And we're gonna submit it. All right. Then we're gonna run it, continue. All right, now we're gonna go back to ClouDNS and we're gonna refresh it, and I'm gonna go to a record and I'm gonna mask the IP address, but I'm gonna show you the lat 3 just to show you that it actually updated, and now the DDNS is pointing to my public IP address. All right. The next step is to set up port forwarding on your router. If you don't know how to do that, you can Google it, just your router name, model, and port forwarding. I'm sure somebody have a tutorial and show you how to do it, but I'll show you how I do on mine. So I have the Amplify Alien Wi-Fi 6 router, and majority of the router now, they have iPhone apps or Android apps. You just can go on the apps and look for the port forwarding, and we're gonna add the first one is gonna be HTTP, which is on port 80, and the IP address is gonna be your Netcloud IP address, which is for my at 192.168.149.4213, and it's gonna be 80 to 80. All right, well, we're gonna add the second one, HTTPS, and the IP address is gonna be the same, 192.168.149.4213, and it's gonna be on 443, check. Okay, so now that we have a port forwarding set up, the next step is open up Safari, and we're gonna go to nextcloud.sysadmin102.tech. Okay, so the reason why you see this connection is not Ryvac, it's because I'm using the self-site certificate. The reason why I show this is because anybody can create the same certificate like you as long as they have all the information. So that's why you see it. If you go to show detail and you view the certificate, you're gonna see it right here, not trusted because it's not signed by the certificate authority, such as Let's Encrypt. When you go to more detail, you're gonna see this is the sales side certificate. I input all the information in here. Alright, and if you click on a visit this site, this website, it's still gonna take you there. Alright, so one of the downside about using a sales site certificate, because nobody certified the authenticity of the certificate, anybody can create one, therefore you are vulnerable to man in middle attack. Somebody can create the same certificate like yours. Alright, and from here you can actually log in onto your Netcloud. Let me see, I'm actually connected to my Wi-Fi. Let me disconnect it. See, there we go. I'm still able to connect it even though I disconnected from my Wi-Fi, just to show you it actually working remotely. So I'm actually on LTE right now, but on the screen recording you still see the Wi-Fi icon. I don't know why, but every time the iPhone connected and I tried to do a screen recording, it always showed the Wi-Fi instead of the LTE. And alright, I'm gonna show you how to set up the Netcloud Wi-Fi app. And we're gonna go to login. So normally you can use the QR code to scan it, quicker. However, because I have a sales side certificate, first you have to trust the certificate before you can actually do that. So once again, I already disconnected from my Wi-Fi, and it's gonna be netcloud.sysadmin102.tech and login. There we go. Once again, this is a sales side certificate. That's why it asks you like, hey, do you wanna trust this certificate or not? You're gonna say yes. All right, and now you can log in. And it's gonna ask for authentication code. I'm gonna get that from my Google Authenticator. 69 and 344. Submit. Grant access. All right, and that's it. You log in remotely. You're able to access this remotely. And that wrap up concluded my tutorial for today, guys. In the next few tutorial, I will show you how to set up let encrypt with pfsyn and hrossy. So that is make the process of renewing the certificate easier. And thank you for watching. If you think the video was helpful, don't forget to subscribe and like. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.